See, if it's not so visible, you tell me, okay? It's not visible. Yeah. So, basically, in the last class, we found that A acting on ket n is root n ket n minus 1, right? And A dagger acting on n is root n plus 1 ket n plus 1. Where n is, so in this case, n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. This case n is equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. Okay. So what about A acting on ket 0? 0. Yeah. So these things you already know. Now to find out the matrix elements of this operator A and A dagger. Okay. So we want to find out the matrix elements of the operators A and A dagger. So that is our idea. So how to find out the matrix elements of an operator? So basically in some representation, right? Some basis. So here basis I am going to consider is the ket n basis. So in the ket n basis, bra m ket n, which is equal to delta m n, and you know the completeness relation ket n bra n summation n is equal to 0 to infinity is equal to identity. So I want to write down the operator A in this basis, ket n basis. So what is the nmth element of that operator in ket n basis? So that you can write it as anm. So what is anm is equal to? Bra n a operator ket n. So here n can take values from 0 to infinity, m can take values from 0 to infinity. So if you write down this, because it's an infinite dimensional matrix, right? It is an infinite dimensional matrix. So what is the A00? What is A00 equal to? Can you just, all of you, calculate and tell me what is A00 equal to? Because you know that A acting on ket n is equal to root n ket n minus 1. And A acting on ket 0 is 0. Yeah? Yes? 0. So this is 0. So what is A01? So A00, A01, A02, like that. So what is A01 equal to?
1.
A01.
Again
0. There are two answers coming from the class. So one is 0 and other one is
1.
So what?
1.
So all of you agree that it is 1?
1. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So it is 1. What about A02? Now you can easily, quickly tell me the answer. What will be A02 equal to?
0.
So anything other than A01 in that first row will be 0. So what about A10? This is A10, right? So what is A10?
0.
Zero. What is A11?
0.
See. What is A12? 0. What
is 1?
root 2, and other things are 0. See, this A operator will take this state to 1 down, right? Because it's a annihilation operator or lowering operator. So this will take 1 down. So the inner product has to be equal to 1, means both of them should be equal to 1. So after this action, this state will should goes to 1, then that should be equal to this. So A 0 0, if it obviously, so A acting on get 0 is 0, so you don't have to do anything. A 0 1, it will goes to 1 state lower, 1 to 0, then 0 0 will be 1. A 1 0, A acting on get 0 definitely is 0, so you don't have to do that. So A 1 2, A acting on 2, so because this is a 2, right? A acting on 2 will take this to 1 down, so A 1 1, so it is a non-zero, but the action of A acting on get 2 is root 2, so root 2. So now I think you can easily quickly tell me the answers, at least without doing the calculation. So what will be this one? So let us write this also root 1, okay? So it's infinite dimensional matrix. Okay. So if that. Yeah?
Sir, where is the video? Completely not visible, sir.
I think full video is completely
blur. Okay. So the next case is A, so this is A 0 3, right? See, this is A 2 3. So next one will be A 3 4 will be root 4, and so on. So can you quickly now write down the operator A dagger matrix representation? So this is the matrix representation for operator A, right? So it's a matrix representation in the Ketan basis. So now let us look at the operator A dagger. Yeah? What are you saying?
Will it be transpose of this matrix?
This will be transpose of this matrix because this it's a conjugate of the operator A. So basically complex conjugate transpose in the matrix case. So this will become root 1, here it will be 0. So also you can actually do the calculation using A dagger acting on ket n is equal to root n plus 1. Ket n plus 1. So in that case, what you can see is A dagger operator nmth element. So this action on mth, so this is, let me do this. So this is A dagger, and action on m will take you to 1 up. So obviously, see, when you find out n and m, so this should be 1 higher, right? So here it is 0, 0, 0, 1. So you can see that anywhere in the A dagger, this line become non-zero.
First row all are zero,
or so don't look at this complex, the transpose of this matrix, okay? As a fresh calculation, is any element in the first row become non-zero because of this reason? See, A dagger 0, 0, right? The A dagger acting on 0 will take you to this 1 up, right? A dagger 0, 1, that will take to another, one more up. So it will never become 0. So all these things will be 0. Okay? And obviously the A 1, 0 the ADAGR acting on ket0 will take this to the next level. So you get A11 means BRA1 ket1 when you act on ADAGR on ket0. So you this one you will be getting root 1. Okay, so this is basically root 2 and so on. Then what about the operator ADAGR A? The matrix elements of the operator ADAGR A. What is the nth element of this operator? Can you quickly do calculation? 2 minutes. What is BRA n A dagger A m is equal to? Pardon me? Yeah, louder.
Same like m plus 1 by 2 del n m. M plus 1 by 2.
Okay, let us see. So this is A acting on, so let us see, do step by step. So A dagger. So A acting on ketem is what? So A acting on ketem is root m ket m minus 1, right? Now this root m you can take it outside. Then BRA n A dagger acting on m minus 1 will be root plus 1 of whatever it is here. So plus 1 of that will give you m only. So root m. Right? So root m into root m will give you this equal to. M BRA n ket m it is equal to m delta n m or n delta n m. So any question on this? Okay. So if you write down the matrix elements for this one or the matrix for this one, how does that look like? Only the, so this is for A dagger, it's for A. So A dagger A, only the diagonal elements will be existing. That will be, so n is equal to 0, m is equal to 0, 1, 2, etc. All other elements will be 0. Okay. So this is a number operator. See, A dagger is a number operator. That's what we discussed in the last class. So number operator acting on M will give you that number itself. So that is the reason M is coming out. So this is A dagger. Suppose you multiply the matrix A dagger with A. Will you get this? Okay. So any question on this so far? Okay, so now let us move on to the next one. So there are certain operator identities. Okay, so the one I want to discuss now is Adamard formula. Okay, so Adamard formula I want to discuss. So this is basically, if I have e power lambda a b e power minus lambda a, so what is this equal to, where a and b does not commute each other. Okay, so in general a commutator with the b is not equal to 0. So I want to have a formula for this. So this is the idea. So for that purpose, what we can do is take this as a function of lambda. Okay, so this f of lambda is e power lambda a b e power minus lambda a. So what will be f prime lambda? So I am taking the derivative of f with respect to lambda. Okay, so this is df by d lambda. So what will be this quantity equal to? Yes? This b is not a function of lambda. So you can take this as u and this as v, or f into g, or f of lambda into g of lambda. Then you can do the differentiation. So first, when you take the differentiation with respect to lambda here, so you get the operator a. These are all operators, okay? F is also an operator. So into same thing you get, right? If you take the derivative, so you get f of lambda. Then you consider this derivative with respect to this, right? This into derivative with respect to this. So if I take a derivative with respect to this, what I am going to get is minus a. So I can write down this as minus f of lambda a. Is it clear to everybody? So the derivative of this one is equal to a f lambda minus f lambda a. Yeah.
Sir, can't the power of exponential be added? E to the power lambda a, then we can add.
Is it not possible? No, what are you saying? What do you want?
In first line, whatever the formula you have written, e to power lambda a and e to power minus lambda a.
Okay.
Can't be added, power can be added.
No, there is a b here now.
So can you take b out?
No, so that's what a commutator of a with b is not equal to 0. That is the whole thing, right? So e power lambda a, I will not write the cap, okay? In other words, these are all operators. B, it is not equal to b e power lambda a, because ab is not equal to ba. If AB is equal to BA, I can take B outside, then e power lambda A plus e power minus lambda, you get B. The answer is B. Okay? So if A commutes with B, then the answer for this is B. But that is not the case. AB is not equal to BA. Okay? So then I cannot do that. I cannot take B to the left hand side. So that is the reason I even kept C. I cannot keep this A after F of lambda, because you are taking a derivative with respect to lambda. So this is the one function, f of lambda, and this is g of lambda. So when I take the derivative here, so I get a outside, then e power lambda a. E power lambda a commutes with a. So I can write down that left hand side. But I cannot, that A I cannot bring it to the right hand side. So A f lambda is not equal to f of lambda A. When will be A f lambda is equal to f of lambda A? If A commutes with B. Okay. Yes. If A commutes with A, if A commutes with e power lambda A. Okay, yes. See, any operator commutes with the function of, any function of that operator. Okay. Always. Okay. Any operator commutes with any function. Because suppose any, you are functions with this, you can write it as a series. You see, suppose exponential of A, I can write down A by identity plus A plus A square by 2 factorial plus etc. So A into A square is same as A square into A. Okay. So that is not a problem because A commutes with A. So any operator commutes with itself because that is A into A is same as A into A. Okay. So there is nothing more. So any operator commutes with any function of that operator. Yeah. Okay, okay. Your voice is too low. That's why. Fine, I understood. Okay, so what are you getting here is f prime lambda is equal to A f lambda minus f lambda A. Now I can write down this f of lambda in a, as a series. Okay. I can expand. So this I can write it as f of 0 plus lambda f prime 0 by 1 factorial plus lambda square by 2 factorial f double prime 0 plus etc. Okay, I am doing a series expansion of f of lambda about f of 0. I can do this. I can also do the derivative f prime lambda also as a series expansion. So that is basically f prime 0 plus lambda f double prime 0 divided by 1 factorial plus lambda square by 2 factorial f 0 plus etc. So now what you are going to do is, see, you have f prime lambda here, right? You have this equation. So now in this equation, equation say 1, you substitute equation 2 and 3. So left hand side, you substitute this one, that is f prime 0 plus lambda f double prime 0 by 1 factorial plus lambda square by 2 factorial f third derivative at 0 etc. left hand side. Right hand side, there are two places you have f of lambda, here and here. You substitute this one. Clear? Now after that what you do is you take the equate the coefficients of lambda, powers of lambda. Okay. So what will be the coefficient, suppose you substitute that, okay. So f prime lambda, you substitute this one, and f lambda, you substitute this one. Then left hand side and right hand side, equate the coefficients of lambda, powers of lambda. So what will be the coefficient of lambda power 0? What is the coefficient of lambda power 0? So, the left hand side f prime lambda, what is the coefficient of lambda power 0 from here? F prime 0. Right? F prime 0. So, f prime 0. What about the right hand side? Right hand side A into f of lambda. So, what is the coefficient of
lambda power 0 in this, that is f of 0.
Zero.
So a f of 0 minus f of 0 a. What is f of 0? What is f of 0? B. So what is this one is equal to? Yeah? This is equal to commutator of A with B. Okay? So now you have to find out the coefficient of lambda power 1. So coefficient of lambda power 0 you got, f prime 0 you got commutator of A with B. So finally if you can find out the all lambdas, okay, you can actually write down f of lambda as a series in lambda. Okay, so first one you got commutator of A with B. So I am just give you 2 minutes. You now find, equate the coefficient of lambda power 1. Okay, so obviously lambda power 1, the f prime lambda is what? F double prime 0, right? So f double prime 0. So right hand side, if you substitute f of lambda here, find out the coefficient of lambda power 1. I'll just give you 1 minute, you can find it out. So what I was saying is this is equal to f double prime 0 is equal to commutator of A with the commutator of A with B. Right? Okay. Yeah. So now you can keep on doing this. So obviously you little bit understood the pattern, right? So next you get commutator of A with the commutator of A with AB. Okay. So finally now I write down the result. So you can find out at least the one more term yourself. So e power lambda A B e power minus lambda A is equal to, so what is first term? F at 0, right? That is B plus next term is lambda F prime 0, that is commutator of A with B 1 factorial plus next is lambda square by 2 factorial commutator of A with B. So next will be lambda cube by 3 factorial commutator of A with AB. Fine. So this is called Hadamard formula. It is very useful formula. Okay. Because you require this formula to do so many quantum mechanics problems. Okay. So now let us look at some special cases. So you can already see that when A commutes with the B, e power lambda A B e power minus lambda is just B. That you all know, because it does not, you can write any way you can write. Now the next important special case is the commutator of A commutes with the commutator of A and B. Okay, that means commutator of A with B is some C, a constant operator. Okay, it's a constant operator. That means some identity operator into some number. Okay, so A with B is C. So this basically A with C is 0. So this is what basically, if you look at the position and momentum, x with b, p, which is ih cross, right? Identity operator. So it is not zero. So there is, it actually constant. So in this case, you can see that you can actually, this term onwards, the second order term onwards will goes to zero. So only these two terms will be there. So if A with B, which is C, which commutes with A with C, basically meaning this is E. Yeah.
Are we assuming that A commutes B equals to C?
A commutes
B equals to C.
No, no. It's not A commutes with B. Commutator of A with B is C. Okay. That means?
Yes.
That means commit AB minus BA is equal to C. When you say A commutes, when you say A commutes with B, that means AB minus BA equal to zero. So it is a constant. It can be an identity operator, or it is some number into identity operator. It's a constant operator. Basically, A commutes with C. So that's all I'm saying. We are assuming. Okay, so I'm saying, see, this is the general formula. Okay, this is true for any A and B. Now, this is the first special case I am talking about. Okay, so one special case, A with B is C. Not just that, A commutes with that C operator. Whatever the C operator, A commutes with that C operator. If this condition is satisfied. Okay. So this is one of the special case of this operator. So A commutes with the operator C, where C is the commutator of A with B. Then you can see that A commutes with C basically equal to 0 means this term is 0 and all other terms are 0. Only the first two terms will be there. Okay. So this is a special case. So there are a couple of special cases we have to do. So this is the first special case, because you know that x with p, the one important thing in our hand is x with p is ih cross identity operator. So that is the C operator here. So, and another thing is, you look at the operator A and A dagger, what we have been doing earlier. What is this equal to? This equal to identity operator. A with A dagger is I. Okay? A dagger minus A dagger A equal to identity operator. So that also comes to this same class. Okay. So here in this case C operator is identity operator. In this case C operator is IH cross into I. Only condition is that A operator should commute with that C. Then you can write down. E power lambda A. B e power minus lambda A is equal to B plus lambda C. Okay. Can I take a couple of minutes? Okay. So let us now look at, suppose this is e power b, okay, let me keep that down as it is. So I just want to do the calculation.
Let me know if I can help.
E power lambda a, okay, before that, you give me the answer, because that is little more complicated. Suppose the commutator of A with B is alpha A, where alpha is some number. Suppose commutator of A with B is equal to alpha A. What will be the answer? This is the second case. B plus
lambda alpha A.
B plus lambda alpha A, because this A with B is alpha A means again all these terms will goes to 0. So here there is no condition that, because obviously the C operator here is alpha A. Okay? But it is one special case because this C operator can be any C operator that just commutes with A. But now the C is just basically alpha A. So there is a one of the special case in this special case. Okay? So now look at the third case. Commutator of A with B, which is equal to beta B. Commutator of A with B is beta B. What will be the answer? What is the answer? No. So what I am saying is commutator of A with B is some constant into the operator B itself. Okay. So obviously the first, this is B. A with B is beta B. But what about this term? A with B, it is not zero. It is not zero. Yeah, this will become beta AB. Okay. Beta commutator with AB, right? That is what is going to become. So, what is again A with B? Beta B. So, what will be this one? Beta square lambda square by 2 factorial into B. Okay?
B into e to the power lambda beta.
B into e to the power, so you are giving the final answer. So B into e power lambda, e to the power lambda beta. This is a beta. All of you understood this? This answer is B into e power lambda beta. Any question? Because A with B will be lambda beta. A with B is, so what we have written, beta B. So A with B is beta B. Then A with, that one beta already came out. Then another A with B, again one more beta B. So you get another two betas, beta square, lambda square by 2 factorial. Here you see first you get one beta outside, again one more beta outside, and one other, so beta cube you get. And with a B outside. So this will be just a series for e power lambda beta, because here is B, this is lambda beta B only. Okay, so you get this one. Okay, these are all very useful expressions. So now I will give you an exercise, you go and do it at home. Okay, so that is instead of B, I am writing down lambda A e power beta e power minus lambda A, okay, e power B, not beta, e power B, with the condition A with B equal to C, and A with C equal to B with C equal to So this is what I want you people to do. Okay?
This expression which you have written the top, A commutator B is equal to, so that is actually e to the power lambda A B e to the power minus lambda A is equal to
A. Which one you are talking about? This one?
In the box. In the, yes, sir. Sorry.
Yes, sir.
A commutator B is equal to B.
Sorry. It is not A commutator B. Okay. So this is actually result for, this is the result for e power lambda A, B e power minus lambda A, okay. This is this answer, okay, where A with B, so this answer is true, this is for this case A with B is equal to beta B, okay. So when A commutator with B is beta B, this answer is equal to b e power lambda beta. Okay, so that other left hand side was wrong. Is it clear?
Sir.
Okay. So here, this one, the nest is the b operator has become e power b. Okay, so this b operator can be any operator. Now it is e power b, but the condition is a with b is a c, and a commutes with c, also b also commutes with c. If these conditions are satisfied, what is this equal to? Okay, so I will give you the answer. The answer is e power b e power lambda c. Okay, so this is equal to this one. If a with b is a c and that c commutes with both a and b, then so this is very important thing, because from this you actually Weyl formula you derive from this. Okay, so you all do this and come back for the next in the next class. Okay, so with this condition, this is equal to this one. Any question?
Sir, in this last case, what was C, a constant operator?
No, that's what I am saying. See, whatever cases we said here, the C is, see, first case this. The first case is this C operator is basically the commutator of A with B. That C commutes with A. That is the condition. That is C. The only case there is C commutes with A. Okay, so I am not saying it's a constant operator. I am saying, so example I given both of the examples, it was a identity operator multiply some number. But only condition required for this answer is equal to b plus lambda c is a with c is 0. Okay, for the first case, a with c equal to 0. If a with c is equal to 0, this is equal to this. C can be a constant operator. That is the two examples I gave you. X with constant or identity operator multiply with some number. That is X with P is IH cross and A with A dagger is identity operator. So condition is this. A commutes with C. That is the condition. So here also A commutator of A with B is C. Condition is this. A with C and B with C is 0. The commutator of that operator with A and commutator of that operator with B is equal to 0. Obviously, C is a constant operator or identity operator. These two are 0. But that need not be true. That need not be required. Okay. C can be any other operator. Only condition is that it should commute with A and B. Is it clear? Okay. So, with that condition, so show that this is equal to this. From that, tomorrow we will derive the Weyl formula. Okay, so you derive this. I will not derive this. You go home and derive this. Okay, so again I want to repeat, this condition here is C commutes with A. Okay, so constant is one special case in that. Okay, here also C commutes with A and B, both. Okay, here only we said that C commutes with A. That is necessary because these things goes to 0 without any trouble. But here it is e power b. So because of that, you need this condition also. B commutes with c. Then you get e power b, e power lambda c. Is there any other question? Okay, if there is no question, I will stop here now. So which is better, the sharing screen or direct?
Okay,
then next time.
One problem is that.
Yeah.
One